On average, roughly 1,200 tornadoes touch down in the United States every year. On average, I miss 1,183 of them. March 24th, powerful tornadoes impacted Mississippi, Alabama, and Tennessee at night. Morning light revealed catastrophic EF4 rated damage in Rolling Fork, Mississippi, where 17 people lost their lives. Tornado. Racing away into the rain, my first tornado of the year was this lousy capture in Louisiana.
Can't see it anymore.
Racing toward me at 50 miles per hour was this killer EF3 in Arkansas.
It's coming right for me. I'm gonna have to run away.
Yeah, it's gonna creep up behind me.
After ripping through Little Rock, this tornado would injure 50 people, and miraculously, only one fatality was reported. However, this outbreak was just beginning. Another large, intense tornado was about to tear through Wynn, Arkansas.
That's a big tornado. It's gonna cross the highway right up here. Looks like the town might take a direct hit.
In its wake of obliterated homes, the EF3 claimed the lives of four people.
Some woman yelled, "There's a woman trapped," and so I ran into the door with a couple other guys, and debris was everywhere, and we went room to room, and there was nobody in there. And turns out that the neighbor, she thought they were home, but they weren't even there, thank goodness. She was holding her dog, and I went up to her and tried to comfort her. She was obviously in shock and said, "Hey, everything's gonna be fine. Everything's fine. The worst has passed." But anyway, I'm at the hotel now. I don't think I'm out of this yet.
Beautiful supercell.
While I was keeping my distance from this dangerous storm in Illinois, over in Iowa, Scott Kearns was documenting this.
Wow, this is amazing. Oh, it's a tornado.
My lizard brain's starting to kick in. I'm starting to get creeped out a little bit. The hook might hit us with some hail, so we might have to run for that, but the cone funnel just sitting there.
Oh!
Oh my God, you wouldn't believe it. We just hit my window. Time to go. Wow. I've got shards of glass all over me. Went north of town, so it's not hit the town.
This large and powerful tornado tormented headstones in a cemetery as it creeped through mostly open country.
This was an amazing storm, and I don't think it caused any major damage, so hopefully everybody's okay, but man, 2023, off to a wicked, wicked start.
Kind of pretty, huh?
The horse is saying hi to all the cars driving by. Oh, wow.
How's this for a gem? Rough green snake, bright fluorescent green on the back, fluorescent yellow on the belly. Super cool snake. You've kind of got
a slight smile.
Looks like somebody bit you on the neck.
Maybe a bird grabbed a hold of you.
Oh, please.
Now part of the car.
Don't go in there or you're gonna be riding with me for a long time. Here, come out. These guys are obviously arboreal
and he likes to climb. Let's take you and let you go. I'm getting hot in here and I know you are too.
The remainder of April brought rounds of photogenic supercells to Texas.
Look at that blue. That is gorgeous.
And the active tornado season would roll over into May. The presence of weather-wise chasers passing through a community often serves the public. One way is we tend to pass down useful information and warnings to any locals unaware of the situation.
Hey. What are you doing? I just saw a tornado. Go home. Go home. Good boy.
On May 12th, it was Nebraska's turn for twisters.
Escape routes everywhere, right? North, east, west, south.
After inflicting EF2 rated damage to several homes, a soggy tornado emerged from the heavy rain. During this outbreak, a few other EF2s were reported. Luckily, no fatalities were.
It's just too wrapped in rain.
The following day, numerous chasers and cattle lined up for the potential tornado show in Iowa.
I see it pulling on the trees. That's so weird.
The herds observed several strange Scudnado thingies.
Thanks, guys.
And another heavily rain-wrapped tornado.
Here's the tornado. Yeah.
Lots of twirly swirls.
Pretty storm today, but all the tornadoes I've seen this year have been ugly. They've either been nasty, rain-wrapped, destructive tornadoes, or they've been really weak, or they've been too far away. Where's my spork? And they didn't have any golden grams at Love's, but they did have Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Not complaining. Actually, I kind of am. But I think between venting to you guys and my Cinnamon Toast Crunch, everything's gonna be okay.
In late May, the chaser horde converged in New Mexico, big time. Hundreds of cameras documented this slow-moving supercell's spectacular lightning activity. Every two-second exposure I shot showcased a unique look with different colors as frequent flashes illuminated various regions of the storm. Can't help but ponder who's the real artist here, the photographers or Mother Nature.
So happy that we found this spot here.
It's wonderful.
On June 11th, devoted chasers intercepted this mean storm in Colorado and pursued it into New Mexico. And then into Oklahoma.
What is up, Ryan?
How you doing, man?
How's your 2023 been?
Oh, it's, you know, it's been interesting.
It's been going really, really well.
Damn. Bolts are shooting everywhere.
While this tiny tornado tickled the ground in Oklahoma, over in Texas, people were crawling out of rubble after an intense tornado tore through their town.
We're in Parrington, Texas, and last night I got hit by a significant tornado. Today I have to drive through Parrington to get to our next target, and I always hate filming the damage. These people, some of them have lost their lives, some of them have lost friends, their property. It's just a mess. And all the locals come in and help them out, and then you're some stranger. I step out of the car and I snap one picture, and this woman walks up to me with a really sad face, and she says, "Are you from town?" And I said, "No, ma'am, I'm documenting the damage." And I said, "How are you?" And she immediately started crying and said, "I lost a good friend yesterday," and just and started crying, and I said, "I'm so sorry." And that's what it's like filming tornado damage. It's it kind of ruins the whole excitement of seeing tornadoes, and it's depressing. And anyway, that's why I never really film damage, and I never really do it well. And I want to do it, and I want to see the incredible things that tornadoes do, but at the same time, I don't want to invade their privacy. I don't want to invade their hardships. I don't want to take advantage of them. So anyway, I documented a little bit of it as just passing through town. For all of those here in Parrington, I hope you have a swift recovery. And for those of you that have lost friends and loved ones, our condolences do go out to you. Hang in there.
In the path of a monster, grasshoppers are a lot like storm chasers. Some calculate their escape and carefully navigate to safety. Others clumsily fling themselves into the winds of fate. Distinct intermediate circulation that's smaller than the mesocyclone and larger than the tornado is often referred to as a tornado cyclone.
Funnel cloud right above me. Little ones.
In case this tornado cyclone abruptly produced a tornado like they do, many chasers navigated out of its path. Others just flung themselves into the winds of fate.
Why are they going that way?
Crazy.
That's incredible.
There's a big tornado back in there, if you look at radar.
It's a freaking monster, man!
After a long day of chasing madness, conditions appeared to be ripening for a long night of red sprites. Far away from the chaos of the storm,
nice.
Magical sights and sounds filled the night.
Man, bullfrogs are loud tonight. Boom! Big Daddy sprites.
Can't help marvel how much bug splatters look like red sprites.
On June 21st, another extremely dangerous storm was tracking over a region with limited roads.
Man, anticyclonic funnel right there. That storm means business. Really gotta get out of here.
While I was giving the storm a wide berth, Daniel Shaw managed to capture and report the intense rain-wrapped tornado prior to its striking Matador, Texas.
That's going right over Matador, God help him. National Weather Service, Amarillo, fire and rescue. Put this down as a possible major incident. It's just behind us at the moment. I believe that's going to impact Matador.
The same day, over in Colorado, Justin Drake and Simon Brewer were bagging one of the wildest tornado scenes of the year.
Wow. Oh my God.
How's your 2023 season been?
It's been going pretty good.
It's a good year. This is a nonstop chasing.
As the 2023 storm season continued scattering multiple targets all over the nation, chasers continued bouncing from state to state.
Hotel
in Pablo at another 5.5 hours to our target area.
At least we're driving on the right side of the road.
Beautiful. Cone, funnel cloud tickling the ground.
On June 23rd in Wyoming, I finally scored some pretty tornadoes.
Tornado just went over hot springs. Let's see if there's any way to get to that sucker. Oh, nice.
Chasing around the scenic bluffs and challenging road network, I managed to eke out a couple more tornadoes as the cyclic supercell moved into Nebraska.
Oh!
After a long, active tornado season, I departed from Tornado Alley, hoping to catch storms in other parts of the world. In Cambodia, the pulse storms weren't too impressive, but the architecture sure was. In the Maldives, the squalls were nothing to write home about, but man, the manta rays sure were. As of the making of this video, 1,165 tornadoes have been confirmed in the U.S. Of those, I missed 1,145.
You ready? Let's go!
And though there's still one more month left in 2023, in December, I'll be flying into the summer, down to Argentina, hoping to capture the photogenic storms and tornadoes that often occur there this time of year. But that will be a whole other story. Till next time, friends, happy trails.